Everything is working together for my good. Oh, for my good. Oh, for my good. Everything is working together for my good. For I know my God is in control. Everything is working together for my good. Oh, for my good. Oh, for my good. Everything is working together for my good. For I know my God is in control. Hallelujah. I want to welcome you to this time of our broadcast, Praise Channel TV. We give God all the glory. Father, thank you for the opportunity to minister again today. Use me to your glory. Use me to your praise. We have a very important topic to discuss today, and I want you to please pay attention, especially in this time of lockdown across the nations of the world. I have something good to share with you. Please come with me. My name is Evangelist Chuks Chidube, aka Praise Channel, This Kind God. Before I continue, please, I would like you to subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking on that red subscribe button, then click on the bell and the thumb up sign there and like our channel. Please leave a comment, okay, so that I will feel you. I will give God glory together. Father, use me to your praise in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. What we have to discuss today, the topic God gave me is lockdown. 10 ways to benefit from it. Lockdown. 10 ways to benefit from it. You know, because of the coronavirus that is ravaging our world in this period of time in our history, people are turned upside down. People are confused. They don't know what to do. People are forced to be at home. I've been in the house for almost 3 weeks. Just like that. I've never experienced anything like this before. But you can turn your pressure to power, or your disadvantage to advantage, your pain to gain, your trouble to triumph, okay? Your trouble to triumph, your test to testimony. So look at what we are discussing today. Quick, sharp, lockdown, 10 ways to benefit from it. So by God's grace, I'm a pastor, I'm a minister of the gospel, motivational speaker, music minister, marriage counselor, and so on. I do several things, but today I'm coming as somebody that will encourage you. Perhaps you call it motivational speaking, whatever, but let's just flow in God's presence. God is here. So I have two scriptures actually, that God ministered to me from. I want to share with you. The first one is Ephesians chapter 5, verse 16. Ephesians 5, 16. Here the Bible says, redeeming the time, for the days are evil. Ephesians 5, 16. Redeeming the time. You have to redeem the time. Don't let the time just go like that. Redeem it. Make the most out of the time that we are in right now, in this generation. Make the most out of it. Then Romans chapter 8, verse 28, very important. Many of us know it. Of course, many know the Ephesians 5, 16. Romans 8, 28. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called, the called according to his purpose. All things work together for those that love God, those that are the called according to his purpose. Do you love God? Are you called according to his purpose? Then this season will benefit you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. All right, let's begin to examine the 10 things to do. Quickly, number one, it's a time to bond with your family. Bond with your family this time. It's a time to bond with your family. I have to read something that a very dear friend of mine wrote. Very dear friend I respect so much. He goes by the name Fela Duro Toye. This is what he wrote. Number one point I said here is bond with your family. Hang out with your children. Make the most of this time. So let's read the 10 things parents can do during this lockdown with your children by Fela Duro Toye. 10 things we can do, parents, during this lockdown with our children. All right. So he said we have to use this time well because we may never see this time again in our history. All right, as long as we live, by God's grace, we are not praying for it to happen. All right, let's go through them quickly. Number one, eat together and play together. exercise, you know, do card games, board games, soccer, whatever you can with your children, eat together, exercise together, play together. Number two, chat with them. Ask questions that will get them to talk, not just answer yes or no, fine, etc. No, create trust and a safe place for them to have open and honest conversation with you. Ask, not interrogate, with the genuine intent to learn more about them and listen attentively. That's the second thing. So have a good time, chat with them, ask questions, allow them to be free so that they can tell you what they have in their, what their thoughts are, right? Okay, number three, do house chores with them. Show them how to sweep, mop, wash, arrange properly. Doing house chores with them will give them a sense of dignity of labor. This may not apply to everybody. My children are already grown by God's grace. They are still growing anyway, but they are big boys. So they do some of these, but you can do it with them to show them how to do it better. Number four, help out with their schoolwork online, because now it's online season. So help them to do their schoolwork online. Yeah. And this what we are reading now concerns all your children, no matter their age. But some of the points may vary the way you apply them to them based on their age. Okay, age bracket. Number five, tell them stories about your childhood. Number six, talk about their dreams and reinforce it. Let them open up to you what their dreams are. Then help them, encourage them through their dreams, you know, all of that. Help them to reinforce it. Number seven, correct their misbehavior with love, patience, and kindness, not anger. And explain consequences of actions on the family, especially at this time. Whatever they are doing, tell them the consequences of these actions. So correct them with love, all right? Okay, number eight, establish the family values and norms and the ground rules that will help your family get through this season with love, peace, and joy. This is the time to do this. Very, very key. Okay? That's number eight. Number nine, explain what you do at your workplace and why it is important. Let them know, actually, what does daddy do? What does mommy do? Explain to them. This is the time. You may never have the time. You know, usually we leave early, come back late, many of us. So we don't really have this type of time. So we are forced to be with them. Let's use it very well. Remember, turn your pressure to power. Number 10, pray together and study God's word together. Have a regular time and place for your family prayer time. Okay? So it's very important that we bond with our family and hang out with our children and make the most of this opportunity. The second point is take time to pray. Of course, we mentioned it in the bonding with children, but take time to pray. Seek God's face. Spend more time in His presence. Worship, praise, dance in His presence. Life is a gift. You are privileged to have this gift that God has given you. Okay, so take time to pray. That's number two. Number three, study the Bible. The third thing you can do this season to maximize this season, to redeem this time. Don't let this time waste. Remember, all things work together for your good, and the Bible has charged you and I to redeem this season and this time. So study the Bible. Try to finish the New Testament or the whole Bible. Just set a target for yourself. Also, read other books. So it's time to empower yourself. All right? Okay. Number four, write a book. You can start writing. Well, by God's grace, I'm writing now, and God is helping me. I'm doing well. Okay. Write a book. Number five, compose new songs. Compose new songs this period. You have the time. Number six, take an online training or course. Some are free. Some are very affordable and cheap. So take an online training or course this period instead of just staying and sleeping, eating. So sorry, maybe adding weight. I don't mean to help anybody. Okay. Number seven, evangelize through the internet. Okay. And evangelize through the internet. Reach out to people through the internet. Preach the word, share the word, and all that. Win souls into God's kingdom. Number eight, learn how to make some dishes. So prepare some meals. Don't just be used to your own local dishes. Learn other dishes that you are not very used to so that you can introduce something new to your family. Number nine, lose weight by spending good time daily to exercise. The right exercise that is good for you. Maybe you need some medical advice to be able to know the right exercise and do it well. And finally, number 10, rest, rest, and rest. When we were in the Bible school, the bishop told us, if you don't rest. You may be laid to rest. God forbid, it's not your portion. So those are the 10 points. Please, it's very important. Let's maximize this season. Make the most out of it and gain the best out of this. Make the most out of this season. Thank you very much for your time. So right now, I want to encourage you to pray with me. If you have not given your life to Jesus, that's the best thing that can happen to anybody in this world. As we give God glory for what we have learned now, may the Lord help us to maximize this season and redeem the time. For all things work together for our good. So if you have not given your life to Jesus and you want to do it right now, please repeat after me. Say, Lord Jesus, thank you for dying for me on the cross. Please forgive me all my sins. I accept you as my personal Lord and Savior. Thank you, Jesus, for saving my soul. In Jesus' name I have prayed. Amen. Say amen. Amen. It's already so for you. Congratulations and welcome to the family of God. My prayer for you right now is that the Lord will uphold you to the end. May the Lord give you all it takes to serve him with all your heart. Devil, I bind you and I command you out of this life. Receive grace to serve God to the end. You are blessed. Now you have accepted Jesus. The Bible says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and other things shall be added unto you. Now you have found the kingdom of God. You have accepted Jesus. I begin to decree into your life favor, breakthrough, miracles, signs, wonders, open doors, new opportunities, international connections. Receive all your heart desires, supernatural healing, supernatural endorsements, supernatural turnaround, supernatural provision, prosperity. Receive all. And of course, grace to live holy and serve God with all your heart all the days of your life. It is done. To God be all the glory in Jesus' mighty name. One more time, I want to appreciate you for your time. My name, one more time, is Evangelist Chidubeke. Praise channel, This Kind God. Please, if you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel, please do. We'll be coming from different angles. We'll talk about marriage, do motivation, do prayer, time, different things, do music, lessons, and everything. So just hang out with me and you will never be disappointed. May the Lord be glorified in your life. It is well with you. Till I see you some other time. To God be the glory and salute.